Researchers at Uganda Christian University warned that conspiracy theories could further entrench vaccination hesitance among the population.
We realized that when COVID struck in 2019, there were many regulations and policies and rules that were put in place by different governments in the world. And while that was happening, some people were actually not responding positively to some of these regulations that were put in place.
In the research conducted by a team of researchers at UCU, headed by Associate Professor Elizabeth Kukunda Bachwayo, a lot of conspiracy beliefs have been developed against COVID-19 vaccination.
Things like hand washing, things like keeping distance, things like not gathering in churches and schools closed. And we realized that at one point some people had stopped actually believing that some of these regulations were necessary.
Professor Bachwayo, also the director of postgraduate studies at UCU, says a three-year research conducted online and physically in the districts of Mbarara, Shema, Kapchorwa, Wakiso, Kabale, Mukono, Arua and Gulu, covering over 1,000 respondents, indicates lack of trust in vaccines.
Most people actually didn't believe that the COVID-19 virus exists. Many people were unwilling to even wear masks, which was one of the things that were supposed to do. A lot of people were thinking that it was the government that was trying to get some money for some reason.
Professor Emily Comfort Maracho, a co-researcher and director of African Policy Center, says government and Ugandans lost a lot from the negativity tainted at COVID-19 vaccination, including lives of loved ones and the economy, which was badly affected.
We have found, as the study indicated, we have found that many people believed that there was something wrong with having a vaccination. The conspiracies influenced them in making decisions about vaccination. And as you know, we lost many lives to COVID-19. And because we lost many lives, it has an economic implication that heads of families died. And that means that the people who worked in those families no longer work.
Maracho says though the government received a lot of vaccines as a donation, it also used the national coffers to buy some, but due to a limited number of Ugandans who turned up for vaccination, more than 40,000 vaccines expired, and again it incurred costs of destroying them. According to reports from the Ministry of Health, Uganda registered 163,301 cases of COVID-19 and 3,588 people succumbed to the virus.
The risk is higher from that aspect of population density because we know that in our schools, especially the public schools or government-owned schools, there is overcrowding in classes, in their dormitories, at places of work. That itself would make transmission higher.
Story by Henry Nsubuga for the news.